Okay, so you got the perfect idea for an app. It could be a mobile app, a desktop app, but you're not a developer and you're not a designer. So you told your significant other about it, she or he shrugged, and that was that. You put the app on the back burner, never really thought about it again. Well, enter Krisspy. This tool is AI powered, and you can simply describe the app that you would like to be into existence, and it will create the front end for you. It's not gonna do the coding part, but it will do prototypes, mockups, so that you can actually take this to a real development team and get it built. Or better yet, maybe you are that developer and you don't want to work with a designer, so you could use Krisspy to do the front end and you could code the back end, maybe use some AI tools for that as well. You could have yourself a nice little business. Now, this all sounds great, but how well does it work? That's what I'm here for. My name is Dave, and I review lifetime deals every single day of the week. I'm gonna be putting Krisspy through its paces, and I'll tell you whether I like it or if I don't. Now, I do wanna point out that this video is sponsored by AppSumo, my very favorite place to buy software online. Each and every week, AppSumo drops new tools to help you grow your business online. Right now, they're running a special promotion where if you buy 3 of the new tools they just released, they'll give you an additional 10% off. If you sign up for their Amazon Prime equivalent, AppSumo Plus, you'll get 19% off of your order when you buy 3 of these tools all at one time. So we're talking about Krisspy today. I recently reviewed Vengo. Do any of these other deals look exciting to you? Drop me a comment down below and maybe I'll make a video about it. My thanks to AppSumo for their support to this channel. Now let's check out the Krisspy deal page. So Krisspy starts off at just $99, but you do need to know that this is going to see a price increase in about a week, 6 days and 19 hours as of the recording of this video. There's currently 4 plans available, tier 1, 2, 3, and 4. The high end gets a little bit pricey, $749. So we'll go through the entire tool and then I'll jump back to the pricing table here. You can see what it kind of looks like. We'll go through it and maybe by the end of the tool, it'll make more sense as I describe the different features and limitations available on each plan. But onwards, here is Krisspy. This is what their user interface looks like. Now with this tool, we're gonna be able to do the full front end mockup, and then you can actually export it to Figma. All right, so let's head into a new project here. I'm gonna click this big plus button, and the first thing it does is ask me to define my product. So I could create a mobile app, a web app, or a web end mobile app, and they do give us some examples here, which is very helpful. So if you wanted some ideas what they're actually looking for here in the description, you could click on FitPulse, a mobile app, and you'll see a little breakdown of what the app requires. So it's a product requirement document. Here's what it looks like for their web app, Tasty Hub. So what we really need to do is if you've got an idea for your app, I recommend taking one of these templates, heading over to your favorite LLM like ChatGPT or Claude, using this as a template, and then describing the app that you want to the LLM, and then it'll help kind of populate things for you. Now, Krisspy does have AI Enhance here, but I find that it's a lot easier to work directly with one of the top tier LLMs, especially if you already have a paid account. You might as well do that. So I have done that exact thing and I've got my document right here. It did take a couple revisions before I actually got the document that I wanted. I'm gonna copy this and I will paste it into Krisspy. All right, here we go. I have pasted in my documents. I can use AI Enhance. Let's see if it does anything here. It might just change the formatting a bit for me. Yeah, it's gonna make it a little prettier. That's nice. All right, so everything looks really good. The user flow is laid out in a way that I find personally a little bit confusing as a non-developer, but everything else is written out in plain text and pretty easy to read. So let's go ahead and proceed to the next step. All right, so it says we're connecting the dots. Krisspy is analyzing your insights to formulate and structure the project. This step ensures that everything is aligned before moving forward. It might take a few seconds. By the time I was done reading the description, it's basically already done. It's analyzed the prompt, and here we go. It says final steps before generation. So I need to give the product a name, a tagline, a description, the problem it's solving, key features, and then I choose a product type down here. I can do a mobile application or a web application. So what I'm gonna do is create an LMS. That's what I wanna do, an online course platform. My goal would be to make it self-hostable so that something like the Once products, right? You could spin up a server, run a script, and then you have your very own LMS, and it's completely independent from something like WordPress. So that's what I'm gonna try to have it do a mockup of. We'll find out how good a job it does momentarily. Now the name here, LearnFlow, is a little too close to another product in the WordPress space for my taste, so I'm gonna think of a different name. All right, so I'm working with Claude here. It gave me some ideas, but you know, they were a little bit bland and generic. So I said, well, how about something from Bill and Ted? And it came up with the idea of calling my LMS Rufus. Love it. Rufus was the educator, the teacher to Bill and Ted. So I think that's a great name for an LMS platform. All right, I've updated the name, and otherwise I'm pretty happy with everything it generated for me. But if I was still struggling, they've got some questions over here. And this is not just a checklist. Let's say I was having trouble defining the core criteria and validation process for onboarding course creators to maintain the platform quality and credibility. Well, I can click right here and then it's gonna ask me some questions. It's actually generating the questions based on the context of this project. Very, very cool. So I could just check one of these answers, like I wanna establish a multi-stage verification system with increasing platform privileges based on course performance. Now, that's not actually what I wanna do, but it might help me brainstorm and kind of figure out where I wanna go with the project. So if you don't start out in ChatGPT or Claude like I did, I think these questions on the side are gonna be much more helpful to kind of flesh out your ideas. And it might be the better route in the long run. But for now, I'm good with everything that I have. Let's go ahead and generate. So here we go. It's actually thinking through the layout right now. It's gonna start building out the screens for me. I'm super excited to see what my new app is gonna look like. All right, so it's just been building out everything here, the entire user flow. And right now it's thinking, but man, it's done a lot of work mapping out this entire application for me. Really exciting stuff. All right, it looks like it might be ready. It's taking me to a loading screen. Almost no time at all has passed. It's generating the wireframe 0 of 26. I don't know if I have enough credits to do this big of an app, but we're gonna find out momentarily. All right, so the actual wireframe generation taking a little bit longer. The first one got done in maybe about 20 seconds or so. If it takes 20 seconds for each one and it's gonna do 26, you know, you might wanna grab a cup of coffee and come back, but certainly not as long of a process as it would be to work with a real designer. As I'm waiting for this to load up, I just wanna mention how the user interface is very, very minimalistic, very clean, and feels a lot like Figma. If you're a designer used to Figma, you're probably gonna enjoy this user interface quite a bit. All right, so some of my screens are being drawn here and I can go ahead and zoom in and check them out. So our first flow is the authorization flow, and the welcome screen, it looks like it has not generated yet, but there is a login screen as well as a registration screen. And then we've got different flows, whether you're a creator, you wanna sell your own course, or if you're a student wanting to sign up and buy a course. So the course creator flow has a registration section where you mention, you know, what your name is, what your background is, all of that jazz. And then as we scroll through, you can see the overall dashboard where you can see the courses that you've built, how much money you've earned, your revenue this month, your active students. Here is the course builder screen. Everything looks really good. Like, I've seen a lot of apps in my time. A lot of them don't look as good as these wireframes, these mockups. So really, really nice. We've got a revenue dashboard here, a student progress dashboard. Here's a landing page builder, a video upload section, and then the course settings where you can set the price and whether it's public or not. Then for the student flow, the onboarding screen has not been created yet, but we've got the student dashboard so you can see which courses you're in and your overall progress, the course grid, an introduction to machine learning. So this would be like what the actual course looks like. Then we've got a video with a play pause button, our progress tracker, and then some bookmarks. So if you're taking the course, you wanna save a particular spot in a lesson. Looks like it built a feature to do that. Super cool. Then we've got a user profile over here, the landing page for the course, kind of like a course dashboard, maybe a curriculum type of thing. And then just a few other screens here, some admin stuff, a help section, your overall account settings, things like that. So very, very full featured. Now I did notice, and perhaps this was user error, but they're still calling the app LearnFlow. So let me go ahead and update this. I'll click on the name, go to overview, and then I can type in the correct name here. I might not have hit enter. I think you have to do that in order to save it. So we should be good. I'll go ahead and change the rest of the description. Just a couple other mentions of LearnFlow. But yeah, while I'm here in the project overview, you've got everything that you just went through in the onboarding. So if you change your mind and you want to redo everything, you could definitely do that. You could change the audience, you could change the key features, and then regenerate the mockups. Now I did have a few of those pretty key screens that just never got generated. So let's see how we can fix that. The auth flow welcome screen, this did not work. So let's go ahead and click on the edit button. And I'm just going to say generate the screen. It's blank and we'll see what happens. So it's currently loading. And there we go, it generated the entire home screen. Now, unfortunately, it called the product LearnFlow and not Rufus, but no worries, I can go in there and edit that. All right, there we go. Very easy, simple change. And now this welcome screen is looking pretty good. Now, I think what this probably should be is more of like a sales page since it's part of the authorization flow. So let me go ahead and regenerate this one more time. I'm going to click on the edit button. You know what? In fact, this time, let's pretend that I was a client and I'm looking at my mockup and, you know, I think I've got some revision requests. I'm going to go and leave some feedback. That's one of the tools up here. So all I do is go ahead and write my feedback in. All right, so I've left my feedback. I'm gonna press the little paper airplane icon here. And now it is ready to go. I can simply select on the feedback. So you can imagine the client goes in and reviews the entire app, leaves tons of feedback. Then you simply go down here, you choose the feedback that you want to approve and create a new iteration. You can either keep the current version or do a brand new version from it. So this is basically like creating a branch off of the existing tool. Now I'm gonna leave it at the current version right now and let's go ahead and create the brand new version. So it's currently initializing and then it's gonna rewrite the screens before finalizing. All right, so the generation is done. It's reloading the project for me. Let's see what that welcome screen looks like now. Here we go. We've got an actual layout of a sales page looking really good. Obviously, there's some changes I'd probably wanna make like adjusting the spacing, but at least it's got the concept right here. Okay, now there's obviously a lot more to check out here, but one of the things you might be wanting to do right away is see what the user experience would be like using this app. So we're currently looking at this view right here with all of the individual screens, but if we wanted to use it in a little bit more of a practical sense, we can go through and actually just play or use the mockup of the wireframes. So clicking on this plus button takes me to the very first screen. And you can see down here, I can scroll through it. I can actually move over to the next screen. So here's the welcome back screen. And here is the create an account screen. Now there are these placeholders here for things like a logo. I could easily add those in the editor. We'll look at that in a moment, but let's just toggle through a few more of these screens. There's a progress dashboard so I can see how far along I am on my courses. I can see my bookmarks. And you know, right here, I think these are a little too close together. So I wanna leave some more feedback. All I do is go over here and I'll see the little feedback widget in a moment. There it is. Go basically to get that, you just go up to the very top of the screen. Here is the feedback widget. And I'm just gonna say that the bookmarks need a little bit of padding between the cards and they probably don't need to be stacked vertically like that either. All right, so I've left my feedback. I'm gonna go ahead and progress to the next screen. Close up the feedback window by just clicking on that to toggle it away. I can continue to view the app. Now I can also preview this just like you would do with like a page builder. You can preview this in mobile responsive mode. So here is the mobile phone view, here is the tablet view, and here is the desktop view. Obviously the mobile phone view is gonna need a little bit of work because right now the menu is not collapsing in the mockup. So let's leave some feedback. Let's adjust the UI to be mobile responsive. Now again, I'm just accumulating the feedback right now. It's only gonna generate a new version when I select the feedback that I want to generate and then click create a new version. So I'm not gonna do that every single time I've got a new idea. That'll definitely burn through a lot of credits. Now let's say I wanted to change one of the screens. We already saw that you could click the edit button and then actually just have it generate a brand new screen. But you can also go into each individual element, let's say like the full name section here. I just wanna change the text, I can click there and I can change the text, no problem. There's also a properties section over here on the right-hand sidebar where I can see a lot more detail about the actual layout and how it's all being organized. There's an entire code section here so you can see how everything is built out. Of course, that is the front-end development, the layout. It's not going to give you a fully functional app. You'll still need a back-end with a database, and yeah, it's definitely gonna require some development further beyond this prototyping tool. But I can officially say that this is very, very cool. We're getting really nice-looking layouts with absolute minimal effort. Now there is an edit with AI button on every single element. So if you wanted some AI help here, like maybe you want to add in another button, you could use AI to do that. Like add in, let's say, I don't know, maybe you want to change it from Twitter to X. Let's see if it can do that actually. That's a good step. All right, so here we go. It should be generating the X button momentarily. It's got the little generation thing here. There it is, it grabbed X. That's almost magical. That was so cool. Now, what if you want to add in some additional content, like you've got ideas for other screens, you just want to make this a little bit more full-featured. There's a toolbar down here at the bottom. There's a plus button on the toolbar where you can actually add in additional active screens if you want. You can generate new screens or edit active ones. You can also create from a brief here, so you're going to generate a new iteration of your screen based on the provided brief. If I click on this, it's basically just, you know, saying, hey, here's what we want to change. We want to fix this bug, we want to improve the design in a certain way. Now, as good as I think these look, they're obviously wireframes. There's no color, you know, they're really boring looking, to be honest. Clean, simple, minimalistic, but very boring. Perhaps you want to have a more interesting and fun application. What then? Well, unfortunately, this is not built yet, but the promise that they have is that you'll be able to click on the little button right here, convert to UI, and you can see an example that coming soon, a high fidelity conversion for web projects is coming. That will be amazing if it looks anything like this mockup. And when you get your app just how you want it and you're ready to move to the next steps, right now your only option is to move this over into Figma. If you click right down here, you have the export options. There's an option to export the screens as Figma designs. It says this is currently in beta, so just be aware it might not work seamlessly, even though that's literally the word it says, but beta, you know, could have some problems. You might need to do it a few times. The other option they're going to have, but again, not available yet, is to download the full React codebase, and that will be amazing. Okay, so that is Krisspy. Overall, if I'm honest, this feels a lot like the first time I used ChatGPT, where it was just like, oh, so it's gonna be like this now. Like those steps we used to do that were super painful and took forever, we can cut those out because the AI can do it for us. Yeah, it's not quite as good as if a human did it, especially a highly trained craftsman that, you know, really, really knows what they're doing. Obviously, humans are still winning right now at the early part of 2025, but everybody knows that AI is catching up really quickly. Krisspy feels like that for UI designers. This could be the absolute future. Even though human designers, I don't think are going away anytime too soon, I do think that AI is gonna be used in those early stages to get the ideas flowing, to get everything kind of mapped out for an MVP before you really come in and put the final touches on things. Krisspy at $99, an absolute slam dunk, but what are we gonna get for our money? Let's check out the other plans that are available. So tier one is gonna give you 300 credits. Now, just for a frame of reference, everything you saw me do, I used 299 credits. Now, granted, I made a very large app with I think 26 different screens on it. So you could easily blow through tier one in the matter of an hour or two if you've got some kind of bigger ambitions. If you're looking to make a smaller app, certainly not gonna utilize quite so many credits. Keep in mind that these credits do renew every single month. So you'll get a fresh dose every month, but that might mean it takes you a little while to get everything dialed in exactly as you'd like. So you can buy a tier with more credits. And with that, it's also going to give you the flexibility of working with another teammate. So maybe you're the idea person, but you've got a developer and a designer that are going to be working alongside you. So tier two is really nice because it's a team of three. I think that's a really good spot for a lot of people. However, you are still missing out on white labeling, which is introduced at tier three. You also get twice as many credits, more than twice as many credits, and 10 team members right here. So this is the plan that I used throughout the video, 1500 credits. But otherwise, all of the other features are going to be available on all of the plans. So we're really just looking at team size and credits. Except if we go down here to the fine print, tiers one and two are mapped to the individual plan, tier three is on the team plan, and tier four is on the business plan. So if new features are added, it's always better to be on the higher end plans because they generally get the new features. But as I always say, only buy the LTD that you'll use right now. Definitely don't buy a higher end tier, just assuming that you'll get to it and utilize it someday. I think this is one of the most easy LTDs to rationalize buying the highest end tier because just think about how much it would cost to work with a designer to do 26 screens like I just did. Hire a designer to make 26 screens for your app, it's easily gonna cost $3,000 to $10,000 to $30,000, depending on who you go to. So you can definitely save a lot of money, especially if you're actively developing an app. Now, what are the downsides of Krisspy? I would say number one, there's not any documentation. Like there's none. There's no way to read about how to use this tool at all. There's one tutorial that they put out, but it's in French without any overdubs. So really you're on your own or you can utilize my video to get you started with this application. So I'd love to see that beefed up. Everything else was fairly steady. You did see the occasional error screen, like it didn't get generated, but it was no big deal. Just click the regenerate button and then it shows up. So yeah, overall a very, very impressive showing for obviously a newer app. It's not been around long. It's still being worked out. There's features that are in beta, but very, very impressive. I'm gonna give Krisspy a 7.9. So that's gonna do it for today's video. If you've got any questions about Krisspy, hit me up in the comments. If you've enjoyed this video, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe if you're new around here. Check out my AppSumo link in the description to support this content. I will see you in the next one. My name is Dave. Thanks for watching.